Wednesday saw the official launch of the Junior Jazz and Arts Festival at the Sandals Halcyon Beach Resort. The initiative, spearheaded by the Castries Constituency Council in collaboration with the Ministry of Housing and Local Government and the Ministry of Youth Development and Sports, promises a stellar showcase of youth talent in various cultural and creative art forms. During her welcome remarks, Mayor for Castries Geraldine Lendo Gabriel gave a brief history of the conceptualization of the event. She says various meetings leading up to the occasion sparked enormous ideas that would direct and shape the overall atmosphere for the Junior Jazz and Arts Festival. She revealed that one of these ideas led to a partnership that would see the event broadcast in 88 countries around the globe.
I spoke to an agency in the US, a radio station in the US, which says that they will be doing that. They actually broadcast in 88 countries and they're preparing to carry the event live. So we're moving our people from being on that stage from this point in time to hitting the world very, very easily.
Dove Productions has been instrumental in providing various opportunities for the growth of youth talent here in St. Lucia. The company, for a few years now, has held its Caribbean Youth Film Festival, which has added to the crop of media professionals on the island. Dove Productions is one of the main partners for the inaugural Junior Jazz and Arts Festival, and its representative, Kimberly Peters, says the company is thankful for the opportunity to further impact the St. Lucian youth.
We are pleased that this coming together for the youth brought together a collective of like-minded people and with determination to establish a platform and provide an outlet where our youth can shine. They deserve it.
Music coordinator Julianne Cyril Myers says the festival provides an opportunity for the talents of the island's youth to be nurtured. She further emphasized that it provides a unique opportunity to tackle some of the bigger issues facing youth at this time.
Our aim is to make changes in the lives of our youth, as would by extension impact our nation for the best. Despite all the social ills increasing at such a rapid pace, eroding the very fabric of our society and the values that have kept us, we applaud the Castries Constituency Council and all stakeholders for this wonderful initiative to help showcase the talents of the youth.
Local Government Minister Richard Frederick, during his feature address, highlighted the government's exploits in providing a more accommodating landscape for the island's youth. He remains hopeful that participants of this year's Junior Jazz and Arts Festival can soar to even greater heights.
In keeping with what is currently transpiring in this country around this time, the jazz time, we felt it necessary that the youth of this country be permitted to showcase their talent. And in that regard, the Junior Jazz Festival was born. It is an opportunity provided to the young people of this country to showcase their talent and to build on that talent henceforth. They will emanate from the schools, from the graduates, and even from the inner cities of this country. No young person should be left out. Artists can display their paintings, and whatever talent you believe you need to showcase, the opportunity is at hand.
The inaugural Junior Jazz and Arts Festival will be held on May 11th and 12th at Serenity Park in Castries from 11 a.m. to 3 p.m. The lineup for the event will be announced soon. For the DBS News World, Jason Darius reporting.